on IOL implantation in the absence of capsular support. I am Professor Dr. Mohan Rajan. I will be talking on recognition and management of PCR. Dr. Amar Agarwal doesn't require any introduction. He's going to talk to us on glued IOL and SFT. Sujata Mohan, Associate Medical Director, Rajan Eye Care Hospital, glued IOL in sticky situations. Manoj Khatri, VR surgeon, is going to talk to us on nucleus dropped and dropped IOL. And Nivian from MNI Hospital, Chennai, is going to talk to us on retro iris fixated lenses. Well, let's start off with the topics. As you know, the most important complication or the deadly complication is the PCR rupture during phaco emulsification. Early recognition combined with advanced instrumentation enabled effective management of posterior capsule rupture during phaco emulsification. It can occur with any stage of PCR rupture at any stage of phaco emulsification, during hydro dissection, nucleus removal, cortex removal, posterior capsule vacuuming, IOL implantation. Anybody in the audience who has not had a PCR at all, posterior capsule rupture? Yeah. Last month, I was presenting in Amritsar. One Sardarji put up his hand. He was an ENT surgeon. He came there because his wife was an ophthalmologist. So early signs of PCR, I'm sure everybody will go through this phase. Sudden deepening of loss of lens follow. Let's go through the case one. If you notice this case very clearly, there is a sudden deepening. Notice this segment there. So there's a sudden deepening of the anterior and the posterior chamber, which is there in this case. Another thing is, again, there's a loss of followability of the lens. What does it mean, the loss of followability? Once a PC rupture occurs, okay, the nucleus does not come into the tip as well as you would like to, despite the fact that you increase the aspiration flow rate and also the vacuum in a, can you just make it about 10 minutes you have done, no? Timing, 10 minutes. Okay, pupil snap sign is the first sign of the sudden contraction of pupil during hydro dissection. When you have, especially in posterior polar cataract and also very hard brown cataracts, with the small rexes, you can have a pupil snap sign because of the hydro rupture, because of acute capsular block syndrome which can occur. So avoid hydro dissection in posterior polar cataract, traumatic cataract, previous vitreoretinal surgery. So look at this video very carefully. Okay, this is a posterior polar cataract which has gone unnoticed. You can see here, as soon as I did the nucleus, this thing, chopping, another patient with the hard brown cataract, as soon as my sister, assistant, puts viscoelastic on the cornea, the whole nucleus goes inside, okay? It drops inside. All these are examples of hydro rupture. Hydro rupture is because when you have a increase in the pressure in the posterior compartment between the nucleus and the posterior capsule, this can open up, the posterior capsule can open up, and the nucleus can drop. So if you have a small posterior capsule tear, then you convert that into a posterior capsular excess. As you can see here, I'm trying to convert a small posterior capsular tear with the posterior capsular excess. Because, as you all know, the posterior capsular excess is much more stronger than a PC rupture. And you can go ahead and implant, in fact, I've implanted in-focus lens, extended depth of vision lens from Papaswamy in this bag, and the patient did very well. What is the most important thing? When you have a PC tear, normally all of us become jittery. Am I right or not? You may be operating on a VAP or a doctor. So the most important thing is to not to become jittery and not to pull out of the eye. Don't pull out of the eye. This is very important. If you pull out of the eye, you are in trouble. Why you are in trouble? Because the PC rupture will start enlarging, number one, and more vitreous is like a tsunami. More and more vitreous will start coming into the anterior chamber. So avoid removal of instruments quickly from the eye. Introduce viscoelastic through a side port. Come to position one on the foot switch. Lower the bottle height. Remove the phaco handpiece slowly from the eye. You can see here what I'm trying to do is, this is the PC tear, and you can see here this is the PC tear which occurs. This pointer is not working. Can you see the PC tear? Can anybody tell me what is the reason for the PC tear? This surgery was done long time back. Anybody tell me what is the reason? It's the post-occlusion surge. I was using a second-generation FACO machine, the legacy machine at that time. And can see here, as soon as I notice a PC tear, I inject viscoat. Whatever viscoelastic, viscoat makes the life easier, inject viscoat. We inject viscoat and slowly withdraw the FACO handpiece from the eye. If you inject viscoat, you stabilize the eye, and then you have time to think, and then create a right side port, and go in and do a bimanual. Don't use the main port, do a bimanual, this thing, wherein the irrigation is separated from the aspiration. And if you have vitreous, you can also do a anterior vitrectomy there, and nowadays we can use even tricot to delineate the anterior vitreous. So the most important thing, if you see the animation, which is by Bobby Osher, you can see here, when you have a coaxial irrigation aspiration, by coaxial irrigation aspiration, what I mean is, the irrigation and the aspiration are in the same port. When you have a PC tear, if you have a coaxial irrigation aspiration, that will enlarge the PC tear, hydrate the vitreous more, and what is a small PC tear will become a huge PC tear right in front of you. So that's what you should not allow to happen. But if you have a PC tear, and if you have an anterior chamber maintainer, that is, you separate the irrigation from the aspiration, then you will not hydrate the vitreous, and the anterior chamber maintainer will tamponade the PC tear and also prevent the hydration of vitreous. Okay, now you can see here, as I am doing the cortical aspiration, this is a posterior polar cataract, then I notice a PC tear. When I notice a PC tear, I inject viscoelastic. Whatever, viscoat makes the life easy, but even if you have HPMC, I'm sure everybody will be having HPMC with them, then create a right side port. And many of you are doing bimanual IA as well, create a right side port and try to remove the vitreous there first. Introduce tricot if necessary, vitreous there, and then remove the cortex and the epinucleus. Okay? Don't go through the main port. If you go through the main port, there will be shallowing of the anterior chamber. If you create a the anterior chamber maintainer, the anterior chamber maintainer will maintain the anterior chamber very, very nicely, and there will be a stable anterior chamber, which is again very important. Case 7, you can see here, as soon as I notice a PC tear, I introduce diluted tricot. Preservative-free tricot is available now, and this is again very important for you to understand the whole ball game. The ball game is, once you put the tricot in the beginning, make sure that the anterior vitreous, which is there, is delineated very nicely, and you can go in and do the anterior vitrectomy. Welcome, Dr. Lalit Verma, Chairman, Scientific Committee. And you can see here, what I'm trying to do is, many people come and ask me, I'm an anterior segment surgeon, how you should do? Very simple. You go in, and you can see here, this is a posterior polar cataract again. There is a PC tear. I introduce the bimanual IA, introduce the tricot. The tricot delineates the anterior vitreous. You need to remove the vitreous, which is there only in the anterior chamber. When you use the cutter, don't use have excessive movement of the cutter. Use high cutting rate, which is now possible because all the FACO machines are now equipped with the good cutters as well. And this is again a posterior polar cataract. I'm putting a lens in the sulcus and then capturing that into the capsular excess. Again, another patient with the PC tear, you can see here how I'm trying to do that with an anterior vitrectomy with a bimanual technique. The bimanual technique is don't use the main port. Don't use the main port. Create two side ports. Have an anterior chamber maintainer. Put the irrigation on that side. The irrigation on the left side, the aspiration, or you can interchange if you want to. That's important. Whenever you remove the aspiration, if you want to introduce the cutter, keep the anterior chamber maintainer always. Remove only the right the side instrument, which is again important. Again, you can see here, this is a posterior polar cataract. You can see here, this is a posterior polar cataract. As I am going out with the posterior polar cataract, you can see here, there is a posterior capsule rupture. So as soon as I see, you can see here, I'm doing a coaxial irrigation aspiration. Till now, I don't see the tear. We do not know whether there's an existing tear or not. But once I see the tear, I come out, I inject viscoat. Okay? Viscoat makes a huge difference. I don't have any financial interest. The Alcon is not paying me a single paisa. I'm just telling you, what important is, you can see here how I'm trying to remove the vitreous first and then remove the cortex or the epinucleus. Remove the vitreous first and then remove the cortex. In the presence of the vitreous, if you try to remove the cortex and epinucleus, what will happen is there will be a traction on the vitreous base, and post-operatively the patient can develop written attachment, written brakes also. You can see here what I'm trying to do is trying to remove the cortex. You can use the suction mode in this thing also and remove the cortex. Every time you come out, inject viscoat into the eye, stabilize the chamber, and then go in for a multi-piece lens in the sulcus and capture the optic capture into this thing. Or you can do what is called a pars plana vitrectomy. You can do here, you can see here in this patient, I had a subluxated IOL, and you can see here I'm putting a trocar and cannula into the anterior vitreous. Okay, into the anterior, for the anterior vitrectomy. If you are not able to put a trocar and cannula, you can do just a simple meningotomy, measuring about 3.5 millimeter for the limbus going through the pars plana. Make sure that the anterior chamber is tight when you are doing the trocar and cannula. Put a suture in there, the thing, because or what will happen is when you put a trocar and cannula, it will start buckling. So that is why, again, very important for you to understand, I'm doing an anterior vitrectomy through the pars plana, which makes much more sense. Once you have assessed, once you have taken care of the vitreous, once you have taken care of the epinucleus and the cortex and the remaining nucleus piece, then you can go ahead and use the lens of choice. If it's a small PC tear, then you can go ahead with a single piece lens in the bag. Okay? You assess the thing, and then if it is a large PC tear, then you can see here, this is a small PC tear. I'm able to limit the PC tear. For a simple reason, I have tamponated by means of the viscoat when they have a PC tear. The most important objective is to make sure that when you have a PC tear, in the beginning, it's about 2 millimeter. At the end of the surgery also, it should be the same 2 millimeter. I was able to put an Envista lens into the bag in this case because I was able to limit the PC tear. If it's a large PC tear, go in for a multi-piece lens in the sulcus. Don't put a single piece lens in the bag. That is a message I want to give. Why I want to give that is important is this single piece lens has got thick haptics, and it can cause UGH syndrome, and all these problems can, secondary glaucoma as well, and all these problems can occur. Now, you have glued IOL, we're going to talk about retro iris fixated lenses. So, when you have PC tear, then the nucleus does not go inside, then you can try what is called this anterior assisted levitation. This can be done by the anterior segment surgeon, and once you have an anterior assisted levitation, you bring the nucleus up. I'm sure Manoj is going to talk about this, or you can do what is called the posterior assisted levitation also. You go through the pars plana, this because I do both anterior and posterior segment surgeries, I'm able to do, but I'm sure by practice, it's not a thing. Only thing is, the PAL, the posterior assisted levitation, don't do it in young patients and high myopes. And all these PC tear patients, we have to follow them very, very closely postoperatively, dilate them every visit and look at the periphery. So the take-home message is prevention of PCR, early recognition of PCR, good vitrectomy, bimanual techniques, and all these will make sure that you have a happy and peaceful night's sleep at the end of the day. Otherwise, the patient will have a problem, you will get screwed up, and all these problems can occur. Thank you, Indore, and thank you, Lalit Verma, for giving this wonderful opportunity. Thank you, AAOS. Now, we go on to Dr. Manoj Khatri, who is a senior VR consultant at Rajan Eye Care in Chennai, and he's going to talk to us on the next problem. After the PC tear, what can occur? What can occur is, you can have a nucleus which is going into the vitreous cavity. How do you know? What you should do and what you should not do? As anterior segment surgeons, what you should do, as posterior segment surgeons, what you should do, and what you should not do is more important than what you should do when you have a nucleus drop. Or a dropped IOL, because sometimes you are in a dilemma, what to do. Better to leave the patient aphakic and take the patient for secondary IOL implantation after 1 month. Okay? Thank you. Thank you very much for this. And we go on to Dr.